In creating a musical, you want to take the audience on an emotional journey that has a shape to it. Little Shop's world is a world that's established right from the very top, you know, with... telling you about the end of the world going into Little Shop. Total contrast into bubblegum rock and roll, and the urchins come out. Little Shop of Horrors, pop, shabop. You never stop the terror, Little Shop. Little Shop of Horrors, and no, oh, oh, no, oh, oh, no, oh, oh, no. Gonna be fun. Then we have that moment of, and you go downtown. Stop downtown where the food is slop. Now we're setting up all the characters. We're setting up the world of Skid Row. Poor. All my life I've always been poor. I keep asking God what I'm for, and he tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep that floor, kiddo. We're just taking you through the whole picture of Seymour is a loser, but he wants something more with his life. Audrey wants something more with her life.
I know Seymour's the greatest, but I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I got a black eye and my arms in a cast. Very touching.
You're sculpting an experience that has to move at a certain pace in a certain way and inexorably keep the audience riveted. And that means you're going, you know, from style to style, from tone to tone, from emotion to emotion, sort of, you know, apocalyptic Phil Spector songs for the Crystals and the Ronettes and the Chiffons.
When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did.
All of these choices for these styles, for these voices, for these characters are drawing on a world. And in the context of that world, we're telling the story. And the story is about what human excesses and human greed does to the world.
Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. That's right, boy.